Hi, this is Narayan. Today I am going to explain creation of Console application .NET Core. First, launch the Visual Studio. Go to File, New, Project. Go to .NET Core node under Visual C#. Here we have Console app.NET Core. Select Console app.NET Core. This one will be used to run the application in cross platform like Windows, Linux and Mac OS. Give the appropriate name in the name text box like introduction. Click OK. Project will be loaded in Solution Explorer. If you didn't get the Solution Explorer window, for example, then go to View, click Solution Explorer. Solution Explorer window will be loaded. This solution contains one project named as Introduction, but you may add any number of projects into Solution Explorer, like right click on Solution, Add New Project, and based on your requirement, you can add any project into Solution. Okay, I'm canceling this window. This solution contains project as introduction. It contains two folders. One is dependencies. If we expand dependencies, here we have SDK. Under SDK, we have Microsoft.NET Core.app. If we expand this one, here we have a collection of predefined assemblies. Okay, here if you click the program.cs, program file will be open. If you create the project in C#, then file extension is .cs. If you create the project in VB, then extension of the file is .vb. This file contains two sections. One is namespace section. This customized namespace section. Okay. To simplify the program, I'm removing this namespace and remove this argument. Here, if you remove the namespace, I'm getting the error like the name console does not exist in the current context. If you want to rectify that error, put the cursor on the console word and click control dot or control period. Here IntelliSense will give the suggestion to use the using system namespace. If you click using system, then it will add in the top of the program. Currently I am removing the namespace. So in the place of adding the namespace at the top of the program, I am adding in each statement. System dot. So here system is the namespace. So namespace is used to categorize the code. It contains a collection of classes, nested namespaces, interfaces, enums, indexers, and so on. If you want to display some output in the command prompt, we need to use console.writeline method. So here system is the namespace and console is the class and writeline is the method. If you want to write some other statement, so we need to write system dot console dot write line introduction. So this is the customized namespace. This namespace contains one class named as program. This program contains one method named as main. So execution of the console application will start from main method. So for every console application, it should contain one main method. So here main method is returning void. That means it doesn't return anything. Okay. If you want to build the solution, then go to build build solution. Here build started, build started, and build succeeded without any compile errors. Once build succeeded, we need to execute the program. We can click F5 to execute the program in debug mode, or click green arrow button. I am clicking green arrow button. So it's executed, and immediately command prompt window will be closed. If you want to keep command prompt, so here we need to add another statement, system.console.readKey. So readKey method will read the read the value from the command prompt. So now if you click a green arrow button, we'll get the output like hello world introduction. Now if you click enter, then command prompt window will be disappear. Main method will be available in different flavors, like static void main string arguments. So this main method is taking array of strings as an argument. So here this arguments will be used to pass the command line arguments. Here this main method return type is void, that means it doesn't return anything. Here this main method returning integer, that means it's returning the integer value. So for that purpose, here we are returning the zero value. If you want to return integer type, here change the return type to integer. So here we are getting one compile time error. So program.main, not all code paths return a value. So we need to return a return value. So here I am returning some dummy value, return 0. Here in these three statements added system namespace. In the place of adding system namespace in all the statements, what I can do, I will remove system namespace from the statements and here put the cursor and control period, click using system, it will add in the top of the program. So and also here the error will be corrected. In the next program, we'll discuss how to pass the command line argument. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.